viewers. My name is Nduhuchile Gloria. I'm a student at Aga Khan University, Institute of Educational Development, East Africa. I'm specializing in early childhood development. At this moment, I'm here to present teaching young children using stories. And I would like to see how we can organize our story lessons as we are going to teach young children. Stories can be organized in a circular form. You put children in a circle, and you as a teacher, you also sit with them so that they see that you are with them and you are at their level. You can also organize the lesson in a semicircular form, and also as a teacher, you are with them in the same circle. You can also have a round table where every child will also be with you, a teacher, and they feel comfortable. What are the advantages of teaching using stories? Stories create imaginative and self-driven skills. Take an example, you have told a story about our transport, and children begin imagining how they can drive their own cars. Even these ones, they also go and look for storybooks and begin reading stories on their own. It also develops sense of responsibility among children. You have told a story in a book about taking care of ourselves. They wash clothes and they are hanging them. Another one can begin brushing teeth on his own. On a sense of responsibility also, a big sister can help a young sister on how to dress and keep themselves, their clothes. It also helps to read on their own, to create reading culture. It also promotes good people relationship. All the time, they share about the stories they have learned and organized to be together and feel comfortable. It also creates or promotes attentiveness. Children become attentive whenever the teacher is teaching them or when they are reading in their groups. It also develops school ownership. When they are going to school, they feel happy. And when they are even at school, they feel going back to school all the time. So wherever they are sharing, they are always talking about our school. It is again another way of knowing that whichever is good also has bad sides. On another side of having disadvantages, it means when you organize lessons or story lessons badly, it means they will create problems among children. Children will hate schools. Take an example, this one is lamenting that I cannot go back to school. Even this one who is going to school is crying, which means stories they have learned from school are not friendly to them. They have hated school. Stories, when they are not well organized, they create boredom. You find children are sleeping in a lesson and they are yawning as if they are hungry, yet the story is poorly organized. It also brings escapism. You find children in bushes, they are running out of school because what the teacher has told them, maybe it is using the language which is not friendly to them. And again, the words being used are embarrassing them, humiliating them, they end up losing hope. Therefore, I request my fellow teachers, whenever we are going to teach using stories, we plan accordingly and we use relevant words and statements which will not humiliate and embarrass children. Thank you very much for listening to me.